Most disciples are not even don't even want to ask the guru, many disciples, because they are scared if the guru gives some instruction which they don't like, it may hurt their ego. Then what will happen? That will be better stay, maintain a distance and continue. Maybe on Guru Purnima, on his Vyas Puja, that's all. Yes. So I personally offer dandavats to all the Vaishnavas, but in my heart I am a disciple always of my Gurudev, my Guru Parampara, and I don't take disciples because of all these things. And even to those disciples who don't want to hear the bitter truth which will hurt their ego, I speak it. I still speak it because I don't care. I mean, I don't care. What I don't care is, I don't care if the disciple stays with me or leaves me. I care for his or her soul. That is the only reason. So, because if I don't speak the truth, the honest, the which may hurt their ego, and I don't present it from the Shastra, the scriptures, then I may be goody-goody right now, but after some time, the egos will again pop up and it will be much more scarier, much more doomsday kind of scenario. So it's better, like Maya herself, Maya, her task is to continuously filter the souls. And those who even try, there are category of souls known as Baddha Muktas. Baddha Muktas means they are conditioned, but they are trying to come out, like aspiring devotees who are trying to, practicing devotees. But Maya even filters them, like whether this is their last life or they have to take many more life. Bhaujan me kari adi Shravana Kirtan. So Maya even filters them. And takes away those who are not ready, and they kind of fall apart. You see, in the case of example, they just fall away. Sorry, rather fall apart. I don't know. Maybe fall away, and but still, it is good for their soul that at least they met someone in their life who told them the truth. Otherwise, like, they would have never got that neem juice. Neem is very important for the body. It kills all the germ, purifies the blood. So it's a bitter neem juice. And the guru's chastisement, when a guru corrects a disciple, then it's for the disciple's benefit. The guru is doing a very surgical operation, very fine things in the disciple's practice and his or her consciousness, surrender to the Lord. And it is preparing the disciple for becoming even more pure. And I was going to say something, but I forgot. The guru is like testing the waters, that how much can a disciple take. Tattva darshina, jnaninas tattva darshina. He can show you the truth, but you have to be ready for it. So a guru can show you nitai, but you have to be ready for it. So the guru has to test the waters. That is why it's Hari Bhakti Vilas in all the scriptures say the guru has to test the disciple. So there has to be a waiting period, first of all, even to accept ashray, not to speak of diksha. It may really hurt the disciple's ego. Why? Whatever I say, the guru is saying it's wrong or chastising. It's not wrong. The guru is not envious of the disciple with what the disciple is going to do. I mean, the guru doesn't have any ulterior motive here. So